Okay, back this morning, flight 2. About as much time as it took to change the battery, and I'm back. We'll do another flight, and Hobo's gonna be a good boy. Aren't you? Yes, be good. Lay down. Okay, that's enough. He is a mooch. Never enough attention. All right. Timer reset. That was without flaps. You can see it didn't jump off the ground like it normally does. So if you want a little smoother takeoff, it doesn't really need flaps for takeoff. It does help get it up quicker, I think. I usually just use a half flap setting, which is about 30% travel. And then my full flap is just 100%. I don't usually, on planes I set up full span ailerons, I don't usually play, like, give the flaps more than 100, because it can make them travel different throw lengths when you're at full travel. It'll runway. I think the wind just shifted to the other direction. Turn, oops. Should have aborted that one and gone around. Went a little long. Long grass to the rescue, I think. Seems fine. Battery hasn't moved.
Take off flaps.
All right.
Throttle cut off. Thank you.
Let's do some 4x4ing with this one, I guess. Seconds means enough time to go around again. Oops.
Takeoff flaps. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time expired.
It's dirty now.
Flaps up.
Anyway, another one. That was another Spectrum 4S 2250C Smart Pack. And other than that, I haven't touched anything. It's a stock plane, other than adding the extra servos. And these are 332s. They're just out of an old EC1500 that I wrecked a couple years ago. Should have that on. But yeah, it's a nice little plane. This is covering a little cut that I put taking it out of the packaging. It was very well packaged. No way it was getting damaged in that, but of course I wrecked it getting out. So anyway, fun plane, flies great, lots of power. Don't think there's anything I'd change other than maybe a little bigger tires, but that's just for here. Anywhere else it's probably fine. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And here comes Hobo.